are here at the Claw Bar talking about the most important meal of the day, which is...
Brunch,
the most important meal of the day, and it's the best meal of the day, if you ask me. We are here with Roy Garcia, who's going to be walking us through a few of his signature dishes. Roy, give us a brief preview of what we're going to be making here.
All right, so we're going to be making our cornbread, homemade cornbread French toast with sweet cream cheese and a miso maple syrup, praline bacon to top it off. And then I also have a shrimp rockefeller omelet that has spinach, bacon, pernod, parmesan cheese, and heavy cream.
My stomach is growling already. And you came up with all of this.
Yes. This is just something that I have laying around. We make the cornbread homemade. We serve it at dinner time. I just cut it in half. I'm going to French toast it.
So I have a feeling once you go cornbread, French toast, you never go back.
Oh.
That would be the new.
Yeah, that's the new.
Okay, let's do it.
Start off with the homemade cornbread.
Homemade cornbread.
We got our French toast batter here. Just a basic French toast batter.
So what's it?
Egg, cinnamon, vanilla extract, a little bit of milk, and sugar. Okay. That's it.
So how, a lot of people don't know when you're making French toast, how soggy to make it? Like how much?
It depends on the bread. See, this cornbread is nice and firm.
Okay.
If you were to go ahead and put something like a thin piece of bread, then it wouldn't work. But it's all about
the bread. That'll hold up. It'll hold up.
Yeah. Okay. Yep. And when you do stuffed French toast, you really want to make sure you get in there. So right now I'm just pouring our butter, because I love to cook with butter. It just gives so much flavor.
That's the only way to do it.
Yeah, just so much flavor. So I'm just gonna dip this right in there. Put my presentation side down first, which is the top part.
Yeah, that's big.
And right now, I'm gonna go ahead and add our Mexican blue shrimp. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cook this till it's about, I'd say, 60% of the way.
Yeah. It's hard to not overcook shrimp. You gotta know what you're doing.
Yeah, for sure. You don't want to overcook it at all. And then right here is my rockefeller mix.
Okay.
So this is the spinach, the pernod, the heavy cream, the bacon.
All the good stuff.
Onion, the garlic, heavy cream.
So this is not for the faint of heart, this omelet. Okay, Roy's not messing around. This is decadence.
Yes, this is awesome.
Huh.
I'm going to put on flat top.
Okay.
Go ahead and put this guy. We got our nice color there. Beautiful color.
Boom. Perfect looking.
Yep. And now I'm going to start my omelet. Three eggs.
Three egg omelet. Real eggs.
Right now we're not busy, so I just always like to do this when it's busy. And we're doing, you know,
you
50 omelets.
Stuff, yeah.
I'll go ahead and crack them ahead of time. But today we have maybe 25 on the books, so.
We don't need to do that.
So you love
making brunch, is that brunch?
Oh, yeah, brunch is my go-to. There's a lot of dedication every Sunday morning. There's 7 a.m. cooking bacon, making biscuits.
That's fluffy. Are you an omelet expert?
Depends on how busy I am.
Whoa!
Got it.
Yeah.
He just whipped that out of nowhere!
Yeah, I am.
That
smells so good.
That is a wet omelet.
That's a juicy
guy.
Yeah, this is like...
Oh my god, that smells so good.
That's it. Just cheese on top. And that is...
Wow! Shrimp Rockefeller omelet. So my problem with brunch is that it's hard to decide whether to be savory or sweet, and it's hard to order two entrees for yourself, you know, because you don't want to be that person.
For sure.
So it's nice to have items like this on a menu that are for the whole table so that everybody can kind of get a little something sweet without feeling like the most ridiculous person.
So I added the sweet cream cheese to this.
Sweet cream cheese. So what's in that?
So this is... the cream cheese, a little bit of powdered sugar, vanilla extract, and sour cream.
Okay, so it's like a frosting almost.
Yep.
Like a frosting.
Yep.
I've never heard of anything like this. Miso maple syrup.
Inside of this miso maple syrup, I start off with miso paste, soy sauce, molasses, a little bit of brown sugar, rice, wine vinegar, and Vermont maple syrup.
And this is that. It's, yeah, soy sauce.
That's
soy sauce. So we'll just add this on top.
So it's that, that salty and sweet.
Yes.
That umami. So
it's like, yeah, it's kind of like when you have like salted caramel. You know? It's like,
oh, it's genius. I, yeah. Look at him go. Oh, that's steamy. But wait, there's more. Oh my god.
Chef Andy's praline bacon.
Oh, yeah.
To die for. Applewood smoked bacon. Pecans and brown sugar.
That is ridiculous. Okay, I gotta get my hair out of the way.
All right.
This is a messy brunch situation. Yep. Okay.
Yeah.
Sauce. Miso. Yeah, it's a lot of flavor.
You're getting rave reviews. The shrimp are a perfect size to get a bite of everything because it's important to get a bite of all the. You gotta try this one too.
That's good.
This is. Oh my god.
Let's try that. The eyes are gonna explode.
What?
Yeah.
Is that good? It's so good.
Oh my gosh. Have you ever heard of anything like this? Cornbread,
no.
French toast. You're a genius. You're a genius. Wow.
Amazing.
This is awesome. We came up with all of this,
yep.
And it's all going to be on the menu pretty soon,
yep.
Here at the Claw Bar. So I'll be back.
Yeah,
probably
sure.
An embarrassing event.
Anytime you guys.